Whether you're a professional welder looking to broaden your horizons, or a complete beginner looking to understand the basics of welding, or even a welding instructor seeking unique educational content for your students, this video was created specially for you. As a supplement to our welding white paper, Common Welding Methods and the Use of Laser Illumination in Welding Imaging, this video consists of four main parts. Introduction, welding processes, imaging techniques, and objects of imaging. Part 2. Welding processes. The main types of welding processes that we are going to discuss are gas metal arc welding, or GMAW, cold metal transfer, or CMT, gas tungsten arc welding, or GTAW, plasma arc welding, or PAW, and finally, laser beam welding, or LBW. 1. Gas metal arc welding, or GMAW. GMAW is a welding process in which a welding gun is used to create an electric arc between the consumable wire electrode fed through the gun and the metals that are being welded. The power source used in GMAW is typically constant voltage and direct current, although alternating current is also possible. Shielding gas flows through the welding gun are an essential part of the GMAW, as the gas protects the melted metals from coming into contact with air and causing defects. Based on the type of the gas used, the process is referred to as MIG, metal inert gas, or MAG, metal active gas. The metal transfer methods commonly used in GMAW are globular, short circuiting, spray, and pulsed spray. The method chosen depends on the purpose of the welding. 2. Cold metal transfer, CMT. CMT differs from conventional GMAW mainly in terms of heat input and arc stability. In CMT, each short circuit is detected and each detection signal causes the filler wire to retract from the welding, giving it time to cool before administrating the next filler material drop. The method minimizes the amount of spatter and results in a smoother and stronger seam than conventional GMAW method. CMT has been found to be superior to conventional GMAW, especially in welding of steel and aluminum. 3. Gas tungsten arc welding, GTAW. GTAW, also called tungsten inert gas or TIG, uses a welding torch instead of a welding gun to form an electric arc between the non-consumable tungsten electrode and the workpiece metals. A filler metal is typically used to join the workpiece metals together, but it is not always required. Similarly to GMAW, shielding gas protects the weld from contamination. The power source used in GTAW is constant current. GTAW is most suitable for welding of magnesium, copper, and aluminum alloys, and other non-ferrous metals, as well as in thin sections of stainless steel. Compared to GMAW, GTAW produces welds with more strength and a higher quality due to the operator having more control over the weld. In exchange, it is slower and more challenging. From the point of view of visualization, GTAW is easier to image than GMAW due to differences in heat and amount of spatter. Four. Plasma arc welding, or PAW. Plasma arc welding closely resembles GTAW, in that PAW also utilizes electrode that is often made of sintered tungsten. However, in PAW, the electrode is located inside the welding torch, making it possible to separate the plasma arc from the shielding gas envelope. As the plasma is forced through the small opening of the torch nozzle, the heat and the speed of the arc increase, improving the heat transfer properties, stability, and shape of the arc. PAW can be used to join workpieces either with or without filler material. Five, laser beam welding, or LBW. In laser beam welding, a laser is used instead of an electric arc to melt the materials that are being welded. Because the heat can be focused on a small area, both the heating and the cooling workpiece surfaces are fast. The biggest benefit of LBW is that it can be easily automated and the heat source is highly concentrated, which makes it possible to produce deep and narrow welds successfully. LBW can be used to weld a variety of materials, such as stainless steel, carbon steels, and aluminum, as well as welding power of the laser beam is very controllable. For thin workpieces, a pulsed laser beam can be used. We hope that you enjoyed this video and you learned something new about welding. By liking, commenting, subscribing, and sharing this video on your social media, it will make it easier for us to decide if we should make more similar content in the future. For more information, please visit our website, cavitar.com.